Donc, this is a very burning question today. What is the best route for the biliary drainage? Because we have this question between the US guidance and the traditional ERCP. But we have different situation. We will see that EUS and ERCP are not real enemy, but maybe more good friends. We have the first situation is benign stenosis or CBD stone. When you have a failure of ERCP, we can use and it's recommended to use the US guided rendezvous to have an access to the bile duct. But more interesting is in case of altered anatomy with prior surgery, mainly in patients with hepatico-jejunal anastomosis or patient with a bypass surgery for obesity. And you will see in this case, the US will help the RCP to access to the bile duct. The second situation is the malignant stenosis of the CBD. And of course, this is the main question. What is the best route to drain the bile duct? The US, the argument is that there is less pancreatitis if you use the US route than the RCP. But also the other question is that what the complication of the US route, like the bile peritonitis, it's sometimes difficult to manage. And also in altered anatomy, this is the main place of the US and the place of a US guided hepatico-gastrostomy, mainly when the patient has a previous surgery like gastrectomy or a patient with a duodenal involvement by the pancreatic tumor. And I will finish my presentation by the place of the RCP assisted by EUS for ILR carcinoma to achieve a better drainage of the anterior liver. Benign stenosis, you will see this is a case of a patient with a huge diverticulum. It was impossible, even with a big expert like Guido Costamagna, to assess to the bile duct. This patient has a CBD stone, and you will see that this is the main interest of the US guided, because you see that the CBD is not dilated. There is no dilation of the main of the bile duct in the liver. And also PTBD is not easy to perform, and you will see that the puncture of the CBD here, it was possible to obtain a cholangiogram here first, and after to pass a wire and into the duodenum, and after to move for an ERCP. With a rendezvous technique. And here you see the wire, and the wire is passed into the duodenum. And after, of course, we exchange the scope. This there is very few paper in the literature about the use of this rendezvous technique for benign stenosis. We have, this is a paper from our study. We use the US for patients with altered anatomy, mainly with a stenosis of the hepatico-jejunal anastomosis. And you see that there is a very good results in 12 patients. 77% of they achieved the treatment with insertion of multiple stents. But the problem of this technique is that 80% of these patients treated need a periodical exchange of the stent every 6 months, because if not, you remove everything, the stenosis will relapse and the patient relapse cholangitis. And this is the technique. The first step is to perform an hepatico-gastrostomy using a metallic stent, fully covered, and you see this is a fully covered 10 centimeter or 8 centimeter metallic stent. And after, this stent is removed one month after, and we can put many plastic stent. This is a 3-7 double pigtail stent to achieve the calibrage of the anastomosis. And this is a kind of assisted the US for the treatment of this benign stenosis. Also, the other interest of the US is the patient with a bypass surgery and that develops CBD stone or jaundice, and the technique of EDGE is a US directed transgastric RCP is to put an axial stent or a lamps between the gastric pouch and the gastric rendement. And this will permit to pass the duodenoscope through the stent 7 days after, 1 week after, and to proceed to the RCP. And this is, I will show you a case. And this is the patient with the, this is the Renman stomach. The patient has a CBD stone. It was diagnosed by the MRCP. And the first step is to perform the puncture of the Renman stomach using, this is the LAMS, the Axios stent, 20 millimeter. And you see the opening of this of the stent here. It was easy, and the first step is to opacify with a needle the Renman stomach, and after we can open the stent here, and we come back 1 week after. Here you will see the the stent, and 1 week after we come back. Here you see the stent is in place. This is the endoscopic view of the stent, and it's easy after to pass through the stent and to perform the RCP. This is another technique of EUS assisted RCP. And we'll see that it's easy to manipulate the scope like a patient with a normal anatomy. In the literature, there is a randomized study. This is a nice study. They randomize EDGE versus a laparoscopic ERCP. And you see that the time of procedure was lower if you use the EUS the assisted technique, and also the length of hospital a day is dramatically reduced in the arm using the US route. But now the main interest and the burning question today is the malignant stenosis of the lower part of the CBD, a pancreatic cancer, and mainly. Here you see the three techniques of biliary drainage, the choledochoduodenostomy with the puncture of the CBD at the level of the bulbus, the hepaticogastrostomy, which is the puncture of the segment 2 or segment 3 of the left lobe through the gastric wall, and to insert a special stent, a long stent, partially covered, or the anterograde stenting, which is the same route than the hepaticogastrostomy, but the stent is pushed anterogradely through the duodenum via the left lobe. This is a quick video. This is the whole technique. The whole technique was to do a puncture of the CBD with a needle. Here you see to obtain a cholangiogram. And after, with using the cystostome, it's easy to push a fully covered stent and to achieve the choledochoduodenostomy. But more recently, we use more often the LAMS, and this is the axial stent, the hot axios with the puncture, the direct puncture of the CBD, and you will see the opening of the stent here. And here you will see the endoscopy image of the stent with the bile, which is coming into the into the bulbus. This technique is very quick and quicker, but they need a large CBD. At minimum, the CBD should be around 2 centimeter. Between 15 to 2 centimeter, we can use the lamps easily. And this is the anterograde stenting, and you see that the first step is to pass a wire into the duodenum, and after to advance the stent through the papilla to open the stent, to pull back to be sure that the stent is not too long into the duodenum, and after to open completely the stent. And this is the anterograde stenting. And finally, the hepaticogastrostomy, and this is the case of a patient with a cholangiocarcinoma of the lower part of the bile duct. The patient receive radio chemotherapy, and after the patient develop a jaundice, and the RCP fail two times to pass the stenosis, and the patient has an external drain. And the goal of the US is to remove this external drain. You see here the puncture of the segment 2 of the liver. And the first step is to obtain the cholangiogram. Here you see the cholangiogram. The step after is to insert the wire. And you will see that it was not possible to pass into the duodenum. In this case, the stenosis was too tight, and also the diverticulum. And this is the main important step, is to pass and to create the anastomosis with the cystostome, the 6-French cystostome, and after the insertion of the stent, which is this is a Jobor stent, 10 centimeter. 3 centimeter uncovered to prevent the migration of the stent, and 7 centimeter covered to prevent the bile leakage. And you will see the opening of the stent here, and with the bile is coming. This is the good length. You need to have 2 or 3 centimeter stent into the stomach. Not too short, not too long. And this is this stent, which is quite mandatory for to perform an hepaticogastrostomy. And this is the CT imaging after the procedure. Safety of cholecystectomy. This is very important. This is a nice paper was published last year. And you see that the pool rate of adverse event was lower than the first study published, because the first study they published during the year 2005, they published a rate of complication of 30%, around 30%. Now, with the new stent, this adverse event has decreased around 13% in this study. You see the worst complication is the bile leakage and the perforation, which is quite low, but not it's not zero. And in the subgroup analysis, the adverse event using lamps was lower, and this was confirmed by these three recent paper using lamps for cholecystectomy. And you see that the clinical success was very high, very good. And the rate of complication lower, it's around 5%. And the dysfunction, the percentage of dysfunction is around 15%, which is, it seems that it's better than the stent when you inserted traditionally using the RCP route, it seems. Cholecystectomy or hepatico, there is three studies. Two studies show no difference in terms of success rate, technical success or complication. Only one study from Europe showed that the complication rate is a little bit higher in the group using the hepaticogastrostomy. ERCP or US BD, biliary drainage, there are in the literature today three randomized studies, one from South Korea, one from the States, and this is a second from Asia also. And you see that the first study include a lower number of patients, but the last include around 125 patients. But this was a randomized study, non-inferiority. But the conclusion is that there is no significant difference in terms of technical success or treatment success. And the only difference is the rate of acute pancreatitis, and the rate of acute pancreatitis was lower in the group using the US route. Of course, it was a zero in comparison to 15% in the group of ERCP route. For me, this percentage of acute pancreatitis in patients with pancreatic cancer, it seems that for me it's a little bit higher than that I have in my experience, which is more around 4 to 5% today with the use of the anti-inflammatory suppository. But we have three meta-analyses last year, and this analysis showed the same conclusion, similar clinical success. The only problem is the type of complication. And the type of complication, like the bile peritonitis, are more severe in the group using the US route, of course. And this is the last one of the interesting meta-analyses, because this meta-analysis has studied only the randomized study. And finally, the conclusion is compared to ERCP, EUS was associated with a decreased risk of pancreatitis. Of course, there is no risk of pancreatitis if you use the US route. No difference in terms of technical and clinical success. But it seems that the patency of the stent using for the US choledochondrodenostomy, even if you use a LAMPS or a standard fully covered stent, it seems that the dysfunction is decreased. There is less occlusion in the group using the US route. And now I finish my presentation on this EUS-assisted ERCP in ILR carcinoma. Sometime in very advanced type 3 or type 4 ILR carcinoma, it's not possible to drain completely the liver using the endoscopic route, and we use this combined procedure. For example, this patient has a 3 stent inserted in the right lobe, and the left lobe was drained using EUS route. And this is the complete drainage of this very advanced cancer, ILR carcinoma, with 4 stent, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you see that there is all the segment, all the liver segment are drained. And this is very important if you want to treat this patient by chemotherapy or radiotherapy or radiochemotherapy. You need to have a complete drainage as possible, of course, because if you leave many segments not drained, you have the risk that the patient develops during the treatment cholangitis or hepatic abscess. And also, you know that a better drainage increases the survival rate of the patient. And this is just to show you this bridging technique that we published recently. which is the possibility to drain the right and the left lobe in patients with a type 2 bismuth cholangiocarcinoma using the US route. And you see that the first step is the puncture of the left lobe, like an hepaticogastrostomy. And here you see the needle, the injection. This is the cholangiocarcinoma. And after using the with the cystostome and the angulated wire, we can manipulate the wire and to pass into the right lobe through the tumor. And here you see the wire. And after we use the coagulation current to pass into the tumor to do a channel into the tumor and to insert deeply the cystostome in the right lobe. And it's possible, of course, to inject contrast with the cystostome, the six French cystostome. Here you see the opacification of the right lobe. And now, and here you see the tumor. And now the trick is to insert an uncovered, first to proceed with a balloon dilation, and after to insert an uncovered 6 centimeter stent here to create an anastomosis between the right lobe and the left lobe, and to have a communication between the right lobe and the left lobe, like this. And you see here the opening of the uncovered stent, 6 centimeter. And after to insert another stent, a geobore stent, to achieve the hepaticogastrostomy. And in this condition, the right lobe was drained into the left and the left into the stomach. I finished this is the endoscopic view of the hepaticogastrostomy. And you will see the final aspect. Of course, we leave a nasobiliary drain in place. And this is the final aspect with the right and the left lobe drained into the stomach. Just to finish, this is a paper that of our department that we published last year. It was about what is the maximum of the liver segment brain with ILR cancer. There was not only cholangiocarcinoma in this study, but also some metastasis from colon or breast cancer involving the hilum. And you see that we need to obtain, if you want, to increase the survival of the patient with a good drainage and to restart the treatment like chemotherapy, we need to have around 80% of the liver drain, and not 50% like it was published previously. And to obtain this 80% of liver drain, we use in this 60 patient, we use in 15 case the US route to increase the number of segment drain, mainly the left lobe. And to conclude, USBD has already replaced the PTBD in salvage or fail RCP in expert center, but now this technique is more diffuse. I'm not sure that today the US can replace the RCP, but the US should be used very quickly when the RCP fail, and not to do too much manipulation with the RCP accessory. And for me, when it's not possible after 5 or 10 minutes to cannulate the bile duct, we prefer to move to the US route than to try some pre-cutting, different pre-cutting technique, which is sometimes difficult and also can induce some complication. But today we continue to start the drainage by RCP as the first choice. But in the future, probably new dedicated tools will be possible to increase and the safety of this technique, and also the growing experience of the endosonographer will undoubtedly push the frontier of this application. And we need, of course, a large randomized study. And I know that this study will probably start in Canada, probably after the problem of this, when the pandemic will be solved. Thank you very much for your attention. And I hope that we can see you for my next meeting in September. I hope that it will be possible to organize this meeting. Today is Monday. This meeting is focused on US endo, and it's an international meeting on international endoscopy and therapeutic US. Thank you very much for your attention. And I wait.